misbehave, I have some rules here. You're going to write the rules, memorize them, and at the end of the class, I'm going to give you a slight quiz on them. So I advise everybody to be on that misbehave. I need you to partner up, boy, girl. If it's two girls, it's fine, too. So everybody partner up, boy, girl, and let's get this show on the road. Here we go. All right, this is what we're gonna do. Partner up. All right, on this side right here, we're gonna split up on each side. On this side right here, the yellow is for the left foot, the blue is for the right foot. We're gonna work on footwork right here. And later on, we're gonna do a drill that you're gonna see why we're using footwork. So what you're gonna do on the yellow side, you're gonna use the left foot, and you're gonna just rotate through. Just like this. Make sure every time you hit the yellow that your left foot is there. Everybody hustle down on this side. So this side right here, we're going to face the wall. This right here is mainly for defense and more of a goal. So you're going to face the wall. You're going to shuffle to the red. Shuffle here, shuffle there. And then once you go through there, come through outside the blue line and get in line, and then come through here and come outside the green line. As you're working your way back, make sure that you're getting your arm loose because we're going to throw quite a few legs. So let's split up and let's get rolling. Let's go. Here we go, hustle up. We're going to work through fast and quick. Make sure you jump and stay low. Here we go, let's go. Good. Good job, friend. Good job.
Another word other than good job.
I know most of you wondering, where is the footwork coming in at? Well, this is exactly where it's coming in at.
Y'all want to play with us?
All right, what you're going to do, when you say go, I'm going to say go. You're going to run here. Most of you guys are right handed. So once you get here, it's going to be just like kicking a pass. You're going to rotate, throw. Same thing, rotate, throw. Again, we're going to do this. But try to be real active. So get in your lines, then that's what we're gonna do. Once you throw all three, get the rebound, set them up, and then next, let's go. Let's go, hustle, let's go. Ready, go!
safety issue. And he's moving the stuff. These are all PDs. We're trying to learn how to play two of them. It's an Olympic sport. It's basketball, soccer, and baseball. You can dribble.
Oh, really?
You can take three steps without dribbling.
So that's the difference between basketball
and baseball. And you notice it's an overhand baseball throw.
But then you have to throw it. Do they pick this for or do you pick this for?
It's already, the curriculum is already set up online, so I just went in alphabetical order. And then I allowed them to swap with each other. Oh, yeah. Really needed to. So, like, we had somebody that was a bowler, a pot bowler. But if he didn't keep them busy, they start misbehaving. And you're misbehaving.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's got a nice strong throw, doesn't she?
I just sent you my new one for you to tell people. I had to change it up.
He took her out. Oh my goodness. But it wasn't a soccer ball.
Oh, easy.
On defense and the O's are on offense.
Excuse me.
So this is going here.
Excuse me. Okay.
All right, now. On offense, this is what we have on offense. Everybody's going to be around. Okay. The best offensive play that we're going to really work on right here and the drill that we're about to do is when the ball pretty much goes to this guy. So this guy got the ball. This defender here is going to be there, there, there. This guy needs to sag here. This guy right here, the easy way to score from here, this guy needs to flash because everybody's heads is focused towards the ball. So if you flash here and get a great pass, then you got a chance of scoring here. Same way on the opposite side. If the pass go here, this guy right here can flash. We can do, since you're coming from the opposite side and you're catching here, you can use the footwork that we use to try and score here. Everybody got it?
Yes.
So what we're going to work on right now, we're going to get a throw up outside the three-point line. Everybody's going to be on the opposite side. And you're going to flash here and then try to get a nice throw.
Ask them what a flash is.
Do anybody know what a flash is? What is a flash?
Flash is running.
Okay. Good. Now I got a question. When is the best time to flash?
Behind a defender.
Yeah.
All right. Good job. All right. Now, another thing. We can set this guy up. Once this guy flash enough, this defender gonna try to be smart and defend him. And guess what? We got another player that can flash over the top right behind. Got it.
Do you think you need to go through that on the court slowly first?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, we're gonna get on the three-point line, and we're going to just flash and get some throws in on the move. So hustle up, get into your spot, and we're going to flash.
Be a lot more scoring today. We've been using the little tiny goals.
Yeah.
So we decided to make them bigger. Which we're supposed to be bigger. All right. So we created our own goals.
Yeah.
That didn't take you long to volunteer.
Thank you. flash. Give a flash. Good job.
He didn't forget about his subs. That's good. How's your stuff coming? How's it going? Oh, nice. Stay on it. It's just like old stuff. Oh, you forget it after a while.
Yeah. Like she gave me a problem. I was like, oh my God, I want to go missing.
Hello.
Watch the black line. Watch the black line. That's good. Good motivator. The drill that kind of boring to talk about. But if you were in high school. Yeah. But you have a class not to let them.
Let's go.
Get back on me.
We're doing fine. I can go talk to just kind of follow the ball.
Thank you.
think of this game. We have a couple of middle schools that do this as an after school activity. Suggestions for next class.
That's all pretty good. The only hard thing to do is the goal height.
Right. You have to kind of subjectively.
Somehow did everybody move.
So you think you can handle two things at once?
With the coaches, maybe. Like what Taylor and Steve do, they'll have two coaches.
Mm-hmm. Here we go, let's go.
We have had it where one PE teacher handled two courts. They just kind of stood in the middle and kind of just called obby stuff, and people had to self-call.
Burn it!
It's an opinion.
Yeah. Oh, nice! Oh, yeah, sure. Right. 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 Get up, get up, get up, get up.
He's a good motivator.
Yeah, he's vocal.
Suggestions for next class.
He said his scrimmage was supposed to be a little longer, so, and his drills were like really good, really thought up.
Yeah.
Good job. Well, the two things are people that never played basketball.
Yeah.
Ryan.
Which we did. That would be Coach Mills.
Coach Mills?
Yes. Not for, can't call him by his first name, he's the teacher. You haven't gotten in trouble today.
I have not gotten in trouble. Well, I should have done that.
Yeah, but so you could have played. Oh, good one. Good one.
Take off. Nice. Take it.
Chelsea's aggressive.
Let's go! You gotta start, Aaron! Go!
She scores. Look at that. Helps to be a javelin girl, huh?
She grew up man, with all the guys.
Yep.
Throughout,
I can tell.
I mean, until her softball time, but yeah. Her brother was real nuts.
That's cool. I kind of. Yeah, I grew up with 12 boys in the neighborhood. So I was a tomboy. That's good, though. I like that. Gives you confidence.
I thought she was
going to
come
out. Good job, Justin. Put it, Chelsea.
Ah! Go! You're a killer, Chelsea.
All right, we go. Hey, two girls, we go. Two girls.
Danica's doing it.
I'm trying to get you, Chris.
Look at this is salary burning activity. Well, he said two girls, but now we don't have two. She's not afraid of the ball. She's a real good. Good job. You won't have to worry about getting your steps
today.
Get plenty. Not her normal self. You are playing well.
I'm sure Patrick the second string is not main was like.
Yeah, you're little cooks. Yeah, you got a little pickled. Oh, good job, Addie. Good job. Yeah. But if you only have one pair of skates, you can do all your demonstrations first and then do the teaching. Separate it out so you can take them off. And just as long as I can see that you can actually demonstrate all the skills. Some people went to the skating rink to do that. Problem is there is the noise. You know, there's the kids screaming. Y'all are kind of gotten this game down. It's easier to learn the rules when you play. Your final exam will not be open book. You don't have to take the rules without kind of like the midterm, except with no book. That's why I gave you the midterm so you can kind of prepare for the final. He's still working on it, but I didn't go to school after the questions that were messed up. The what?
It was like
yes, yes, it was. It was counting 12. It should be 6. It was a 3-meter. I fixed that one, and there was another one that had compass. Yeah, those were the two that I corrected. So everybody should have had an increase on their score. score. If you go back and look at it. I did that over the weekend.
So we take the final E-class?
Yeah, in the step. Whenever the final of this stuff, I think it's on a Tuesday.
2.5 minutes, let's go.
Almost time.
Go!
Score. Good job.
8-7. Yeah. Let's go.
You too. Wow, that's a little bit different, huh?
Yeah.
So you will not be missing Ms.
Houser.
Ms. Houser. Mrs. Houser. Wow. You have to get used to that. Score. Nice job.
Let's get it.
It's almost time. Got a couple more minutes.
Hey, good job again, guys.
The ball's coming.